Welcome back to Road Notes. So, if you're like me, there are just certain foods that you love to have, but unfortunately, they're super expensive. There's a few things in life that probably everybody has that they would love to have more often, but it's kind of cost restrictive. Well, for me, sushi is one of those. I love it. It's ridiculously expensive nowadays. So, we decided to give something a try. We're going to show you what it is and how you do it. Stay with us.
Maybe road notes.
So, we're gonna try to make sushi at home. We've tried this before using one of the bamboo rollers and it didn't go very well. We had a lot of problems. So, Mark found this nifty little gadget on the internet. It's this sushi making kit, and it's got all the little tools and different pieces to it, knife, etc., etc. But it comes with this cool tube that helps roll the sushi and spit it out. So we're gonna try to make sushi with this. I went to Publix. Asian food stores will also be really good for this, but I didn't have one close by. I got some of the seaweed rolls. These sheets were about $4 and change, and there's nine in here. And I purchased sushi rice as well. So I spent about $10 for the ingredients between the two, and then we've got some avocado and some other things that we're going to use for the rolls. So keep your fingers crossed because we might be on to something for homemade sushi. So the first thing you need to do is follow the sushi rice directions. This is the brand that we're using for this, and it uses 1.5 cups of rice for 2 cups of water, but you have to soak it for 15 minutes before you cook it. So we're gonna prepare this, soak it, cook it, and then I believe it stands after that for 10 minutes after this. So I'll show you what it looks like when it's all done. In the meantime, I started getting some prep work done for the sushi. We used some wild salmon, and I cut some cream cheese, and we cut some crab sticks, and we're gonna use some carrot sticks and some avocado. And then we're gonna make some, I don't know if you want to call it spicy mayo. I call it sriracha mayo, but I'm gonna make it from scratch. a good sriracha mayo only really takes a few ingredients. Soy sauce, hot sauce, mayo, and sometimes I'll put a little garlic in there. So you just put them all together to your taste, let it sit for a bit, and it's ready to roll. So in the meantime, I'm gonna get some avocado ready, do a couple other pieces of prep work. So this is the little device that Mark found on Amazon. It's a plastic tube. It has a wand that comes with it that goes and fits in the groove. You can see it's got the groove mechanism and it gets tucked in. You fill it and then we're gonna close it and we're gonna wind the sushi out into a roll. So our sushi rice is done. It's, as you can see, it is like crazy sticky. So I'm letting it cool down just a little bit before I start building the rolls. But once the steam lets out, we're gonna build. I've got some green onion, some cucumber, I did some avocado, and then I've got the rice and our crab and salmon. So we're gonna just play around with some simple rolls. I'm not into doing anything too extravagant this time since I've never really made these. And I'm gonna try to roll them and then put them into the seaweed sheets. All right, prepped and ready. So let's see if we can do this. So first thing you do is fill each side up with rice. I don't really want super heavy rice rolls, so I'm gonna try this a little bit thinner the first go round and see how the roll actually comes out. So it goes in both sides of the tube here. Super crazy sticky rice. And I think, dry my hands real quick. For this first go around, we'll do basic avocado and cucumber. And then on this side, I think we'll go ahead and use the salmon and just do a salmon and cucumber roll. I have another package of the Nova if we need it, but I need to figure out how much rice you can actually make out of these. So, no cream cheese on this one, but I will put it on the next one. So we've got that, and I'll go ahead and probably throw a little bit of crab in there with it, just a smidge. All right, so here's our wrap. Smooth side down, okay. I don't really know how to tell what the smooth side is. Oh, maybe that's it. Okay. So this locks in place like this. And it's got this little twister. See if I cannot make a huge mess with this. And obviously I gotta hit this right. Turn it. Already tell I got a little bit of a problem here. All right, let's see what happens. Okay, I could see it was a little bit better on the other end where the rice was a little thicker, but that's something we can fine tune. So now we wrap it and roll it. Got a pretty decent placement. And gotta wet the end. And wrap it. And you can see the end that actually the sushi, I had a little more rice on that end. It seems to have come out pretty good. So I think what I need to do is just put more rice in the rolls, but you can see it's We got a full sushi roll. I'm gonna let it cool, and I'm gonna work on the next one, and I'm gonna show you what we're gonna put in it. So the second one I did here is a cream cheese, green onion, avocado wrap with the crab and the Nova. And this one I put more rice in. This one's gonna be mine because Mark typically doesn't do cream cheese. And I've already made a mess, but that's all right. So lock it in like that. Get my next paper ready. And see how it goes. Oh, now this one came out a little longer than the paper. Hey, yay, yay. Now it's going to be stuck. Let me see. All right, well, what we're going to do then is we're just going to break this one. I'll eat it separately. I'm just going to roll it up. There's definitely an art to this. I see why people have serious skills for this kind of thing, which I do not. But I've still got the roll put together. So, and it's kind of fun to make it myself. So even though I have this one piece coming out the end that's a little bit of a problem, I'll go ahead and cut it off so you can see. Let me get the knife. This, we have a set for this. We have a special sushi knife for this, but I'm going to use the serrated that we have, and I'm going to take this end piece off and you can see what we've got. And I'll go ahead and cut it. And you can see you've got real sushi. I may not be ready for Nobu yet, but it's definitely a nice little fun weekend project to do. And I bet it's gonna taste really good. The nice thing is you can control what you're putting in it. And you have as little or as much as you want.